What's up, good people? I just had a thought. I thought it was about, it came from our article, it was inspired by our article that Jay-Z, his new net worth is $2.5 billion. I thought, man, that's pretty cool, it's pretty amazing. But the article still says that he has still not cracked the top 400 richest people in the world. Top 400. Of course, top of that small mound, 400 people, $251 billion is Elon Musk. Then I giggled to myself. I gave it to myself because every now and then I have someone compare me to Elon Musk. They hear my ideas about what I want to do, and I don't share my ideas with everybody. I share them with a select few that I feel like have they're open-minded to hear my ideas of what could be done in the world. They're like, oh my God, you're like an Elon Musk. And, of course, I'm like, I still don't, you know, that doesn't resonate with me just yet. Because I'm not, in my mind, I'm not at his level just yet. One day I'll be there. But not that, I don't believe I'm at his level yet. Belief is something you keep thinking, you keep thinking, you keep thinking until you believe it. I haven't gotten to that momentum yet. But then my next question was like, well, shit. Why the hell hasn't Jay-Z or Kim Kardashian or any of these billionaires, why they've been at it for 10 years plus, you know, figuring it out, and they got to, you know, reach a very, very amazing level of $1 billion. It's pretty amazing that you're bringing in $1 billion every year. You have created such amazing connections and relationships and business, is that's the revenue you bring in. That's pretty amazing. But it pales in comparison. It's like a little small, you compare it to $251 billion. It's like, man, if you've ever just compared, because I do this all the time, I just like to visually see, like, okay, what does that sum of money look like in volume? You know, have you ever seen $1 million before? You know, I haven't seen $1 million before, but I saw $700,000 before. That's crazy. Crazy that, like, that I could even just see that. I mean, if you can visually be in a space where you can see $700,000 in your physical sight, that must mean something about you and your energy, right? So I know that I'm destined for billions, right? Because I saw $730,000. It was some ridiculous. One day I walked into the bank. This is totally outside. But just, it's just so freaking cool how the universe gives you these little signs that, like, bro, you keep doing it, man. Don't get distracted by what people think, what people say, what they're doing. And so what? You're single still. You're 40 years old. So what? You ain't got no damn kids. Like, so what? Like, so what? This is how it's supposed to go. Just give yourself to it. Like, let it be. Other people have their life because that's what they want. This is not really what you want. You don't really want to have any fucking kids. Not right now, you don't. What's more important to you is your achievements. Those are your fucking kids. You know, like, this is what you're doing that brings you excitement. But anyway, I walked into a bank one day. BMO, that's where I bank with. And randomly, there was 730, maybe 740. I remember seeing the tag. I knew it was $700,000. $700,000 sitting on the countertop. Randomly. How often does a bank have $700,000 in cash just sitting on a countertop? That doesn't happen often. Because usually you imagine that shit being involved. You know? They were very, very comfortable about this shit, which is kind of leads to the value of money, maybe, I don't know. But anyway, but that shit was meant for me to see it. That's my point. I was meant to see that. I was meant to say, oh, that's how that much money looks like in volume, right? So 700,000. So my mind, you know, my mind is crazy. I started to multiply that shit. That's almost, it's like, you know, 3/4 of a million. 3/4 of a million. Be right here. So I started multiplying and I started to see if that was like multiplied by multiplied, how much space that bank would be filled up, how much room would it fill up, right? Yeah, that's exciting, man. It's exciting. It's not even the money that's exciting. It's the idea that expectations matter. Some person could achieve that. Like, that is like, I'm pretty sure that, that's gotta feel really, really, really good. Not even having the money, that the idea you can just achieve that level of financial well-being. Okay. But back to my point. Why has Jay-Z not done it? Why is he at a billion, $2.5 billion, whereas Elon is at $251 million, right? And I thought to myself, okay, I get it, because Elon is a really, really big thinker, like myself. He thinks really, really big. I think probably so much so people don't understand why he thinks so big, like why he thinks so big. And I don't think he tries to, because I don't really try to think big. I just can't, I just literally can't think small. It's probably the reason why I struggled in school. So funny. I struggled in school. Well, I didn't struggle in school. I never struggled in school. The school was a little bit harder for me than most. I didn't struggle ever. But I had to work harder at it, because school is very small thinking. But ideas like SpaceX, Tesla Motors, which he really didn't create that shit. He bought it from someone else and he made it better. He didn't create it. SpaceX, I believe, was his. I mean, there's no proof to say that wasn't his idea. And even his idea on creating roads under the ground, I think it's an amazing concept, but the practicality, I'm not sure. But anyway. But, I mean, that's his idea. And he's done a really, really amazing thing with those things, right? Long story short, these ideas are not like small ideas. And, you know, Jay-Z doesn't have small ideas. In music, his liquor, I believe his small ideas he has. Music, that's what I mean. But it's not as big as a Tesla Motors or as big as a SpaceX project. Like, these are like grandiose, humongous, like huge ideas. And so when someone says that, I remind them of Elon, I think, man, damn, you know what, there's a spark in there to think that, like, one day I could be at his level in that list of the top 400 richest people in the world. For the money? Nah, not for that reason. For the achievement? Fuck yes. Like, fuck yes, that's exciting as fuck. The scariest, most exciting thing I've ever wanted to do. But really, just to see that, like, how far can I push it? That's really my thing. Like, how far can I go? I know the sky's the limit, you know, but how far I'll go in the years I've left and lived in this world, like, you know, where at one point would I say that I had enough? I don't really see that I would ever say I've had enough. Honestly, I really don't see a reason to. It's just so addictive and exciting and scary and life-giving, and it's like it stretches me to my ends. So I just don't see myself ever stop doing it. It's just like it's too much damn fun, you know. Coming to the point where I'm like, I'm scared as fuck. Like, I don't know what to do. I'm stressed out. And then coming out of that space and being like, But I can't quit. I gotta keep going. I gotta keep going because I just can't stop doing it. I love it. I just really love it. I'm probably sure I'm supposed to feel that way about a woman. It's probably the reason why I don't have a woman, because I don't feel the way about any women like that. Like women I just want to be so committed to, that just like this thing, I'm scared, but I don't want to let their asses go. I ain't found that yet. Not in a woman. I let a lot of women go, and I don't regret that shit. But this shit, oh my god, that's exciting. I want to spend the rest of my life doing this. I have ideas that are like fucking huge, like huge ideas, like world changing, like on a global grand scale ideas. And slowly, one step at a time, I'm learning the skills that's gonna help me to get to that point where I can manage those ideas, manifest them, and manage them, and I don't stress myself the fuck out and gain like 300 pounds. But yeah, I think that's what the difference is between like a Jay-Z or Elon. I think the dedication is there for Jay-Z to do that. I'm not sure if he wants to be the richest man in the world. I'm not sure if that's his ambition. Neither is my, that's not my ambition. I just want to push it really, really fucking far. Like, I want to do the shit nobody can do. And Elon is at the top of the list. So I just want to do the shit that he looks at me like, damn, how did you think of that shit? Where did it come from? Oh my god, that's amazing. Like, that's an amazing idea. I didn't even think about that shit, you know. That's how far I wouldn't push it.